Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, a fine, fantastic funster, Soupy Sales.
Thank you, and thank you, Chet. It's a pleasure to welcome back to the panel the mighty mouse of all this rat pack. Would you say hello to Anita Gillette?
Thank you, Sue.
Okay, Anita.
I would like to introduce a suave, bon vivant, raconteur, man about town, Mr. Gene Rayburn.
Wow, that's me. Thank you very much. What's happened to the chairs here? I gotta rearrange the furniture before I do anything else. Now, you've all heard of great chess players being called chess masters. A great game player, a TV game player, is called Arlene Francis.
That's right.
Right. That's what I said.
Now, a funny thing happened on the way to the forum. The terrific producer of that show was with us, Larry Blyden.
Good day, all bodies.
Good day, everybody.
Good day. Good day, good day. Well, it's a lot. Listen, Gene, you know, talk about... I tell you what a successful life player is called, is Gene Rayburn. I mean, you should get a survival award for this year, the things that have happened to you.
Tell one.
Hasn't been my best year.
Like, for example, one of the things happened was that he got a brand new show in which he was absolutely marvelous and then spent all the money for the second 13 weeks and it was canceled after the first 13. Then he went back to his house and discovered that it had burned to the ground.
That's two.
By the people that canceled the show.
Yeah. Yes, but you didn't hear the other one. He had a factory going for him, for himself up in Cape Cod.
I didn't know.
And that burned down last week.
What was that?
He made Lucky Charms.
Okay, Soupy, let's see how you'll be. How lucky
one,
you'll be today.
Why did they turn on me for one and they love you for two?
That's it. I don't know if it's a seat, I think. Well, listen, you're going to meet two guest challengers today, and later on you'll meet a mystery guest, but right now it's time to meet our first guest. So, first challenger, and would you come in and sign your lucky charm, please? Audrey Norris.
How are you today?
Mrs. Norris, where are you from?
South Bend.
South Bend, Indiana. Panel, at the age of 61, Audrey Norris gave up show business and embarked on a new career. Now, 16 years later, at the age of 77, that new career is going strong. She performs a service. Let's show the audience what her line is. And we'll start the questioning with Gene Rayburn.
I can't believe you're 77, Mrs. Norris. You look terrific.
I'm glad you don't.
Mrs. Norris, this service you perform, do both men and women use this service?
Oh, yes.
And when you perform the service, do you come in physical contact with the performee?
To talk to them, yes.
To talk to them, yes.
To the people, but when she's doing what she does, she is not in contact with them. So that'll be one down and nine to go, Arlene.
And the fact that you look so marvelous does not mean that you try to impart this kind of information to other people, does it?
That is correct. It does not mean that.
Is there, do these people come to you, to your place of operation?
I usually go to them.
She goes to them. All two right. Down and eight to go. Soupy?
Is music ever involved in this?
No.
Music. No, music is not involved in this. Three down, seven to go, Anita.
Mrs. Norris, when you perform this service, do you use any equipment at
all?
Oh,
yes.
Is it something that you hold in your hand, or you could hold in your hand?
Oh, yes, I can hold it in my hand.
Uh-huh. After you have performed...
Part of the equipment she can hold in her hand,
right.
At least.
Yeah. After you have performed the service, would you say that the person has benefited in a physical way from...
Oh, no.
In a physical way, no. 4 down and 6 to go, Gene.
Well, the implication, then, is the person has benefited in some spiritual way. Is that correct?
No.
No!
5 down and 5 to go, Arlene.
Do you have anything to do with the way a place looks or changes?
Yes.
Would you be even remotely connected with anything to do with the construction business or the plumbing business?
No.
Well, very remotely connected with the construction business, but
yeah.
Very remotely.
But not plumbing.
But I get a half plus for that.
You get a half plus for that.
Do you work indoors?
Sometimes.
Do you have anything to do with growing things?
Nothing to do with growing things. Let's throw them all over. You will never believe this, but Mrs. Audrey, she is a house painter. That's right.
Right. Got it.
Terrific.
Construction. That's it. You were right.
Miss Norris, why was it that when you were 61 years old, you suddenly decided to be a house painter?
Well, my children kind of took over my occupation of singing and dancing, so Grandma had to go into something else.
Your house needed painting, right?
Your children and your grandchildren both?
Yeah,
are in show business?
They're all in show business.
Good.
Could you go up a ladder, Mrs. Norris? Can you go up a ladder?
42 foot.
No.
No.
You get dizzy up there? Are you afraid of heights at all?
No.
How long have you been going up a 42-foot ladder?
Well, I went up 108-foot already 8 years ago.
Holy
cow. A water tank, you know.
What's the hardest thing about painting the inside of a place?
The inside?
Mm-hmm.
The neatness.
Mm-hmm.
That you have to be careful of not getting it on the people's rugs or... That's all.
Do you have any difficulty with wives and or gentlemen wanting exactly a certain color, and if they don't get that, then they make your life miserable?
Oh, I don't tint paint. When they want a different color, I have my men paint tint the paint at the paint shop.
Oh, I see. You have someone else mix it, and then you just apply it.
Right.
But can you tell with your eye whether or not it's accurate or not?
Well, pretty well.
Are you pretty good at it? Okay, panel, let's find out how your eye is for matching paints. It's a tricky business, and we're going to test you for tint, shade, and hue.
Oh, lovely.
Lloyd Gross, would you open the curtain, please?
We don't even have a Lloyd Gross.
Jennifer, you want to push the paints down?
Okay, now here we are.
The color on the board here has already been mixed from these three primary colors, blue, yellow, and red. Now, your job is using only these three colors to mix a color that will match this one. You have 3 shots at it. If you miss the first time, redo it and go for the second one. If you miss it the second time, go for the third one. Okay. Whoever gets closest to it wins, and Mrs. Norris is our judge and our final authority as to who has won. Okay, the teams will be Arlene and Jean and Anita and Soupy. If you come over now and put some smocks on.
Smocks.
Larry, this one's
smocks. All right.
No, I'm sorry.
If you give me 2, or I'll be your friend if you'll give me 2.
All
there
right.
You go, Gene.
You help the lady?
On,
and I'll help
myself. Yep. Right.
Back to front like a hospital gown?
Yeah.
Right. Sutures?
I'll take your temperature in a minute. As soon as I've scrubbed up here.
Some people I would never
you, trust. Come on, sweetheart.
Right,
I think we start with yellow,
no
don't
blue.
We?
Right, no
okay,
blue.
You ready?
Are you ready for this?
I'm colorblind.
Now, don't use too much paint all at once because you can't, you'll run out.
All right.
All right, on your mark, get set, go.
What are you supposed
to do? All right.
No, I think there's a little blue in it.
Put a little blue in it. All right, just
very
a little bit
little.
Of blue. That's it. Not much. Now, wait a minute. To your health.
How do you mix that?
Well, what you have to do is you have to put a little more in.
Oh.
Like you're making a...
That'll be delicious when you get it ready.
I think I need a shave.
Oh, I thought it was a mirror.
Don't use too much. That's going right. to be too blue.
All right, then we got to put some yellow in if you get too
you
blue.
You should start again because that yellow is going to be not strong enough.
All right.
Put it in the yellow.
Okay, that one I ruined
that.
That
one. That's going to be green.
All right.
All right, now just put a little... That's all. Just a little.
Just a dab.
We should have mittens. No,
wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold everything.
Okay. Wait a minute, I think we're close.
Who has the olives?
Yeah, wait a minute.
That's right.
Try this out. No, too light.
Too light.
Too light.
Too light.
Here, put a little more green in it. A little more green.
Hurry up.
Green.
Give not me. Too much. Just a minute.
Oh, wait.
Oh,
by Joe, I think she's got it.
Can I have some?
some of your yellow?
I wonder where the yellow went when you brush your teeth with birdseed.
Now, wait. No. A little more red. A little more red. Okay.
What makes it browner?
What makes it browner? Let's put a little red in.
That's a very good idea.
Very little, very little. Don't get hysterical.
That's All right. That's it, Soupy.
We got it.
Wait a minute. But
bring the prizes over here, Miss Norris.
Oh, that's it. Oh, by Jove.
That is it.
By Jove, I really think you got this time.
Oh, that's add it. Some pecans.
Yes, that's
right. That's it, Soupy.
The only red that's not in here is skeleton.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold everything. A little more.
That's it.
No, that's wrong.
We got it.
We got Ta-da. It.
They're closer, I think. Ta-da. Yes, we are.
Come on up and judge this for us.
I think they've used... Try this. Hold everything.
What do we got?
Wait, I think we've got it. Now we've really got it.
Through the bottom.
There it is.
There it is. That's it.
There it is.
No, we got it.
No, you haven't got it.
Okay, Mrs. Norris, who is the closest?
We got it first.
Mrs. Norris, who has won?
Look at that.
We've got it right here.
There. No, wrong.
Which one, Miss Norris?
That's
hold it, hold it.
Wrong.
Don't tell me I'm wrong.
Who's
I'm
won
a star.
It, Miss Norris, who would you say has got it?
Okay, Soupy and Anita.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Mrs. Norris.
Know what's my line. Thank you.
Okay, we'll be with you. We'll be back to meet our next challenger in just a moment.
Anita, you won.
Yes, we won, but it was all because of me, because you know what? Soupy is colorblind. He couldn't see anything.
Are you really colorblind?
Oh, I really am. I really am.
Isn't that awesome?
That explains his jacket.
I know it. It's yours.
Okay, let's continue. Will our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Dr. Ray Eskin.
Oh, nice to see you. What's going on?
Where are you from, Doctor?
From Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania.
Panel, Ray Eskin is a doctor of psychology. He is not, however, working in that field at present as a doctor of psychology. He is involved with a product. And now we will show the audience what psychologist Eskin's line is. And let's start the game with Arlene Francis.
Now, let's see. Do you have anything to do with something to eat?
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with something that could be found in a jar or a package?
Yes.
Yes, he does.
Is it something that one would have at mealtime?
Not necessarily.
One conceivably could in the most luxurious
exotic?
Kind of meal.
Right.
One conceivably could.
Is it an accessory to that meal rather than the main thing that you would eat?
It would be.
Yeah.
Is it something you might... It's a luxury product?
Well, yes and no.
That's about as good as you can say it.
That's true.
Is it anything...
Or even as well as you can say it.
Is it anything that was ever alive?
Was it ever alive?
In a sense...
In the broadest possible sense, but I'm going to give you a no on that one, and it's one down and nine to go. But it was in a sense. Okay, Soupy?
Doctor, is it anything in the fish family?
No.
Fish family, two down and eight to go.
No, it might have been eggs.
is it?
No, I think she established that it came in a jar or in a package.
A jar or a package. When you say a jar, may I assume that this does not mean a bottle, or?
Well,
I mean,
some refer to jars as bottles.
So I guess you may not assume that. Okay, three down and seven to go.
Where did it wrong?
What did she assume, that it comes in a bottle or a jar?
May she assume that it is not a bottle, and we said no, you may not assume that.
Oh, so it is a bottle, right?
Well, it can be, yeah.
It can be.
All right. Is there a liquid in with this stuff? I mean...
None at all.
None
no
at all.
Liquid. Four down and six to go.
It's dry. Is that correct?
Dry.
I see what you mean, Anita.
It's put in the mouth and swallowed.
Oh, yes. Yes. If you chew it.
Is there... If you chew it.
I tell you what, I'm going to flip them all over just in the interest of time, even though it's a marvelous and fascinating thing. Dr. Ray Eskin is a nut salesman.
Oh, very good.
You
was employed by the Pittsburgh Snacks and Nut Company, Inc., as a nut salesman. How many different kinds of nuts do you sell?
Well, there are 64 varieties and kinds, packages and so on. But there are better than 24 different kinds of growing nuts, which include your sunflower seeds and...
I didn't know that was included in the category of nuts.
They're called sunflower nuts now.
Saints preserve us. I didn't know that.
For the health food people.
Give me a bag of sunflower nuts.
Doesn't sound right. How would you like to package some panel nuts?
How long have you been selling nuts?
Since 1945.
I see. And do you plan to go back to psychology someday?
I think I meant it every day.
It's a nutty business.
Yeah. A person is in the nut field, they're in it. Thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line. What's My Line continues after this word. Time to play Who's Who on What's My Line. So would you open up the curtain, please, Lloyd? And here are four lovely people from our audience. They are a secretary, a day camp director, a nursery school teacher, and a machinist. The problem is to give each person the card with his own occupation on it. We'll start with Soupy Sales. You got 20 seconds. Go. You've got $25 and a gift apiece. Okay, Anita. Nursery school teacher, day camp director, secretary, and machinist is correct. You did it, Anita. And that's marvelous. Okay, your team has won $25 and a gift for each of you, but before you go, would you tell us who you are, nursery school teacher?
I'm Shirley Zoltansky from South Bend, Indiana, and I teach nursery school.
Terrific.
My name is Stephen Smith, and I'm from Brooklyn, New York, and I'm a day camp director.
I'm Barbara Doherty from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and I'm a secretary.
I'm Albert Durgan, machinist, Fremantle, Massachusetts.
Okay, thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line. Each member of the Who's Who team will receive a Samsonite Silhouette Softie, the casual carry-on suiter featuring three compartments for efficient packing. Samsonite, we make travel a little easier. Okay, panel, blindfolds all in place?
Place.
Okay, will our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? One question at a time now. We have 2 minutes to establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll start the questioning with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Larry. That was a marvelous ovation, mystery guest. Is that because we would find your name in the entertainment sections of the paper?
Yes.
Anita?
Are you a singer?
No, no, no.
Jean?
Well, are you best known for your work in television?
No.
Arlene?
Motion pictures?
Yes.
Soupy?
Were you ever nominated for an Academy Award?
Yes.
I know who it is. Is it John Voight?
John Voight. No, it's not John Voight, but it's a beautiful try. Anita?
I'm confused. Are you in something that's currently playing and you know, a new picture out now?
No, no.
Are you a member of my sex?
Gene!
Define that.
Oh, that's good.
Okay, Arlene.
Give me a loan with 5 minutes with Anita Gillette, and I'll tell you what.
You didn't define it, so we still don't know, right?
Right.
It gotta be a lady. Because
right.
The laugh was too big on John Voight. Are you a lady?
Yes.
And truly a lady. Soupy?
Oh, are you best known for your work on Broadway?
No.
No, I think we established that she was best known for her work in films.
In films?
Okay, I tell you, take off your mask because we're out of time and say hello to Joan Fontaine.
Oh, Arlene!
She was not only nominated for an Academy Award, she won it for this picture.
John Voight's going to like that.
That was a marvelous guest, Soupy.
Let's hear that voice again, Joan. I never...
Why?
What was that?
Very good.
I tell you, in addition to being colorblind, you got a severe hearing problem.
But everybody else that went around once, they thought Joan was a guy.
Listen, we're going to have to break for a minute. We'll be right back on What's My Line. Joan, stay for a minute, will you, please? We'll be right back after this message. Listen, we're back, Joan. I didn't realize that.
That's right.
You've had such an incredibly varied career. Of all the things that you've done, which is your favorite, would you say?
Bridge. I like being a civilian. I'd never get a chance to be one, but if I had to choose, I'd like to be a civilian. But and play golf. That wouldn't be bad either. Yeah.
But you could stop anytime you want to. Why don't you?
Because it's like being in a boat without oars. If you stop working, you have no control. You've got no breeze, no tide, and anybody... Absolutely. The bigger ship comes along and you're in trouble.
Well, before the boat sails and the wind dies, goodbye, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow on What's My Line.
The biggest event in blackjack is back, Jack. GSN presents the World Series of Blackjack, an all-new season.
I'm so incredibly good at this game.
Because they're playing for a king's ransom, we're bringing back the Burger King Power Chip. The World Series of Blackjack, an all-new season, tomorrow, 11 p.m., 10 central, on GSN.